हेलो एवरीवन, लेट्स स्टार्ट लाइंग डाउन ऑन आवर बेली टुडे। इन शास्त्रांग नमस्कार। सो फीट सेपरेटेड, हिप विद अपार्ट, टोस पॉइंटेड अप, बोथ आर्म्स स्ट्रेच्ड फॉरवर्ड। यू कैन चूज टू ईदर प्लेस द पाम्स डाउन, इफ यू कंफर्टेबल जस्ट जेंटली टचिंग द पाम्स टुगेदर। टेक टाइम टू स्ट्रेच बोथ योर लेग्स आउट, आर्म्स स्ट्रेच्ड आउट, इनहेल जेंटली लुक अप, एक्सहेल फोरहेड डाउन। Moving awareness to belly. Let the belly expand and contract naturally. Now slowly start relaxing your shoulders down for the next 15 seconds. One more deep breath in, let the belly expand completely. Exhale out slowly. Lifting the head up, let's come on to our forearms for Saral Bhujangasana. So elbow shoulder in one line, fingers are pointing forward and feet are still separated hip width apart. And we're going to roll the thighs in. So usually the thighs roll out at times, so rolling the thighs in. So pressing the thighs firmly, inhale, lift chest up. You're looking forward, eyes closed. Moving awareness to your lower back. Keep both your legs stretched out and active for the next 30 seconds. So thighs are pressing down, top of the feet pressing down, knees are slightly off the floor. So if you can lift the ribcage up a little bit more, 5 more breaths here. Using your chest to breathe in and out. One more deep breath in, expand your chest as much as possible and exhale out through your mouth, bringing your forehead down. Let's walk our palms one step back by the sides of our shoulders. Elbows are pointing up towards the ceiling. Let's join the feet together now. If you have an existing lower back pain, keep the feet separated. So both legs are stretched out, you're pressing your thighs. Spread the fingers wide. Inhale, lifting your head up. Only the head lifts up. See if you can lift the chin up. So you're crunching the back of the neck. And use your back muscles to slowly lift the chest up. And as you're crunching the back of the neck, start stretching your arms, lifting the belly slightly off the floor. Bhujangasana, I can't talk when the neck is stretched out. So stretch the neck out and stay here for the next 5 breaths. Elbows close to the body and arms can straight out till you can keep the thighs and the pubic bone down. Shoulders relaxed, chest moving forward. We'll stay there. Use the expanded chest to breathe in and out. Feel the stretch in your abdominal region. One more deep breath. Exhale, forehead down. Palms beneath your shoulders. Let's come on to all fours for 5 cat-cow stretches. Fingers spread wide, toes tucked in. Inhale, drop the belly and the chest down. Bring the shoulder blades closer. Stretch the neck and head up. Press your toes firmly, exhale, rounding your back, chin to chest. Inhale, cow, squeeze shoulder blades, head up.
Exhale, cat. Rounding your back, draw the belly in. Shoulder blades moving nice and away. Three more rounds. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And last round. Inhale. Exhale out fully. Come back to neutral spine. Let's come out to our knees, hands on hip. So you can fold the mat into two if you feel any pressure in your knees. We'll keep the toes pointed out. Thumb touching your hip bone at the center. And other four fingers around your waist. Exhale out fully, draw the belly in. Let's start moving the thighs forward. So press the top of the feet nice and firm. Moving the thighs forward. Draw the belly in, lift the chest up. Let's bring the elbows close to each other. So as you're moving your thighs forward with the support of your palms, see if you can lift the chest a little bit more up, squeeze shoulder blades, dropping the head back for the next 5 breaths. Look forward, coming back to neutral position. Let's sit down in Vajrasana, bringing the hips down. Simple cross leg. Let's lift the right leg. So, you're going to place the sole of the right foot onto the right elbow and the right elbow hugging the right knee. Okay. So, sitting up taller, so right foot is slightly flexed, pointing towards you. If this is uncomfortable, you can hook the elbow beneath your shin to hold on to the leg. So let's sit up tall, both sit bones are down. Gently start moving the right knee out and the right heel in. Keep breathing for 5. I repeat, right knee out and the right heel in. 4. You can use the support of a right palm to move the right knee even more. 3, 2, sit up tall, and 1, slowly stretch the right leg in front of you for Janu Sirsasana. So the left heel comes close to the groin. Let's start with the right knee softly bent or bend it nicely so that you can hold on to the right foot with both your hands. So nice and tight grip, inhale, lift chest up, lengthen spine, press the sit bones down. Left thigh is pressing down firmly and slowly start scooching your right heel forward, stretching the right leg out. So, along with the right thigh, you're bringing the upper body also down. Take your time, right foot pointing towards you, tighten right thigh. Next 7 breaths, inhale, ribcage moving forward, you're gazing at the right big toe. Exhale, you're trying to press the belly close to the thigh. Any excessive rounding of your back, spine. Back off and bend the knee, both more on stretching the spine and go slow. With your breath, every exhalation, try to stretch your leg a little bit more. Deep breaths out, every time exhale, squeeze your belly in for 7. If you can, place the chin beyond your knee, placing it beyond the knee. 6. Keep pointing the foot towards you. 5. If the leg is straightened out, press the calf muscle down and the thigh down. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Inhale, straight elbows, lift chest up. Gently look up. Exhale, chin down. Let's walk our hands back. So the left leg remains in the same place. We'll stretch the right leg to the side for a twist. Okay. So we're going to hold on to the inner sole of the right foot. If you can't get the access, bend the right knee gently. Holding on to the inner sole of the foot, we're bringing the elbow inside the knee. With the knee straight or the knee bent, you're pressing the left thigh firmly. So place the left palm onto the left thigh. Press the right elbow down. Inhale, open chest out first. You're pressing the hip, open chest, rolling the left shoulder up. Now engage your left leg more. Right toes pointing towards you. Next inhale, left arm reaching over your head. And slowly see if you can hold on to your right foot with your left hand. If that doesn't happen, it's perfectly okay. But keep opening the chest. Avoid closing the chest. But mindfully opening the chest as well the ribcage wants to point up towards the ceiling. Those who want a deep breath can bring the shoulder inside the knee. And with every exhalation, rolling your left shoulder back. You're trying to place the back of the head on the knee. 5 deep breaths out. Keep pressing the hips down for 5. Especially the left side of the hip. Keep moving it down. 4. Stretch the right leg out. 3. And 1. Slowly closing your chest, walking your hands back. Let's stretch both legs out. Feet separated, hip width apart. Hands are behind your hip, toes pointing forward. So as though you're resting onto your palms, but keep the chest lifted up. Simple stretch for the ankle. Inhale, pointing your toes out. Exhale, point the foot towards you. Press the calf muscle. See if you can lift the heels off the floor. Inhale, pointing your toes out. Press the heels down. Keep the chest lifted up. Exhale, pointing the foot towards you. Heels off. Press the calf muscle. Tighten thighs. 3 more rounds. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, one last round, inhale, hold the breath in and keep stretching your ankle for 3, 2, 1, exhale, hold the breath out, press the calf muscle, tighten thigh for 3, 2, lift chest up and 1, release. Simple cross leg. Oh, thighs feel so nice. Let's lift the left leg up. You're going to place the left foot or the left sole of the foot onto the right elbow and the left elbow hugging the left knee. So it's a nice and tight grip. Again, option to hook your elbow if you can't hold on to your shin. So point the left foot up. Now you can place the left palm onto the left knee. And gently start moving it away from you slowly as you try to bring the heel closer towards you. You're sitting up taller, choice to keep your eyes closed. We stay here for 5. Right knee is down, lengthen spine. 4. Keep moving the left knee away from you. 3. 2. And 1, releasing. Let's stretch the left leg out for Jhana Shirshasana. Let's keep the left knee bent and bring the right heel close to the groin. Holding on to the left foot with both your hands. Inhale, stretch your spine, shoulders relaxed. And slowly start scooching your foot forward. And keep pointing the left foot towards you. With every exhalation, press the belly close to the left thigh, tighten left thigh. Inhalation, use the grip of the foot to move your chest and the crown of the head forward. Gaze either at your big toe. If you can bring the chin down, eyes closed. 7 deep breaths out here. Keep tightening your left thigh and keep pointing the foot towards you by moving the left heel out. Exhale out fully. Inhale, straight elbow, lengthen spine. Exhale, release. Let's walk the left foot slightly towards the left side. So according to the openness of your hip, so both sides of the hip has to press down. So don't move it too away so that the buttock lifts up. So you're on your sit bones. Left toes pointing towards you. We'll turn the palm around, holding on to the inner sole of your left foot. So the left knee can be bent to start with. Bring the elbow outside the knee. If you're able to do that, you can try and bring the shoulder outside the knee. Choice is yours. Now, place the right palm onto the right thigh. Open chest out, rolling the right shoulder out. Ah, side muscles feel so good already. Choice to stay here. If you want to deepen, inhale. Right arm reaching up towards the ceiling. And slowly trying to hold on to the outer edge of your left foot with your right hand. If your knee is bent, if you're trying to straighten the leg out, bring the elbow down along with the knee. Now 5 breaths to open the chest up and keep pressing the right side of the hip down. Deepen your exhales for 5, 4, 3. Those who can place the back of the head, can place the back of the head on the leg. 2 and 1, closing your chest, exhale that and slowly walk your hands back. This time we'll stretch both our legs out so that you're on your sit bones. Heels down, toes pointing up. If you're not able to sit up straight, keep the knees bent. Fingertips in front of you, let's point the toes out. Inhale that, exhale pointing the foot towards you. Press the calf muscle and the sides of the glutes, tighten them. Inhale, point the toes out. Exhale, flex. Tighten the sides of your glute mindfully. Inhale. Exhale. 2 more times. Inhale. Exhale. One last time. Inhale. Lengthen spine. Exhale. Press the heels firmly. Toes are pointing towards you. Let's bring both our hands towards the right leg. Okay. So upper body is turning towards the right leg. You're pressing the left thigh nice and firm. Inhale, lengthen spine. And slowly start walking your hands forward. Choice to keep your hands down itself without holding the grip. Or you can hold on to any part of the right leg to bring the chest and the chin down. Not the crown of the head down, chest, chin or the forehead down is also okay. So if you are holding on to the grip, I am holding on to my foot, you can hold on to the shin or the knee. Keep gazing at the right big toe. Same practice, pressing the belly closely when you are exhaling. Inhaling, imagine somebody is lifting you up from the diaphragm and then placing the chest back on top of the leg. Choice to keep your eyes closed. And mindfully start bringing the left thigh down for 5. Those who can, place the chin on knee, placing the chin on. 4. Keep pointing the feet towards you. 3. 2. And 1. Exhale out. Let's walk both our hands back. Oh. Back feels nice. Lengthen spine, pointing the right toes up. Sit up tall. Exhale out fully. Inhale, lifting the right leg up. Exhale, right leg down. Inhale, right leg up. Keep the chest lifted. Exhale down. 3 more times. Inhale. Even if you're trying to lift, that's more than enough. Exhale down. Last 2. Inhale. Exhale down. Last 1 to hold. Inhale. Holding it 5. Choice to lift your left arm up. 4. Engage your belly. Right arm up. 3. 2. And 1. Releasing. Shake your legs off. Before we move on to the other side, just join the soles of the feet together. Keeping the soles of the feet nice and away so that your thighs relax. Palms facing up. Stretch your arms up. Head down. So visualize the crown of the head wanting to touch the floor. So ideally you are keeping the feet nice and away from your body. So
So every time exhale, relaxing your shoulders, neck and head. Few calming breaths here. Exhale out fully.
Walk your hands back, lift chest up. Let's get back to the starting position where the legs are stretched up. Okay? So you can start with the knees bent if you are not able to sit up straight. Now toes are pointing either up towards the ceiling or ideally pointing towards you so that the heels are pointing up. Let's turn our upper body towards the left leg but keep pressing the right thigh down. So the right side of the hip will gently lift up, which is okay, but you are mindfully trying to keep it down. So stretch both your arms on either side of the left leg, active legs, inhale, lift the chest up, exhale, slowly start walking your hands forward. You're trying to bring the belly on top of the left thigh, holding on to any grip that works for you. Inhalation, you're lifting the chest up from the diaphragm, lengthening spine. Exhalation, press the right side of the hip and the belly down. If you can, place the chin on the knee or beyond that, go ahead and do that. 5 deep breaths up. You stay there for 5. So my right side of the hip is lifting up nicely. So I'm going to walk it in slightly. 4. 3. Keep pressing the right side of the hip down. 2. And 1. Exhale out. Let's walk both our hands back. Pointing the left toes out, draw the belly in, exhale out fully, inhale, left leg lifting up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, keep the spine straight, slight rounding is okay, inhale up, exhale, 2 more, inhale, exhale, one last one, tummy engage, straight spine, inhale, lifting up, see if you can lift the right arm, and the left arm, holding it. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Releasing. Let's bring both feet on mat. So, feet is separated hip width apart. Palms behind your hip. Few dynamic movements here. We're just going to lift the hip up and bring the hip down just off the floor. Okay. Press your feet firmly. Inhale. Lifting your thighs and hip up. Roll your shoulder blades closer. Lift chest up. Keep looking forward. Exhale, dropping the hip down gently. Bring the hip closer to the floor and bend the elbows little bit. Inhale, straight elbows. Lifting your thighs and hip up. Exhale, slight bend in the elbows. Hip comes down just one step. 3 more times. Inhale. Exhale. Don't forget to bend the elbows gently when you're exhaling. Strong legs. 2 more times. Inhale. Exhale. And last round. Inhale. Lifting the thighs up as much as you can. Choice to drop your head back for 5, 4, 3, 2, look forward, bend the elbows a little bit deeper than the last time and slowly lowering the hip down just off the floor, holding it. 5. You should feel the stretch in your triceps. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Let's bring the hips down. Coming up to standing. Interlace fingers, give a good stretch to your body. Lengthen spine. Take your time, just lean towards the right side, exhale, inhale, come back to center, exhale, bend towards the left side, inhale, center, exhale, right, inhale, center, tighten thighs, exhale, left, inhale, center, one last time, exhale, right, stretch both your elbows, press your feet firmly, Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Again, feet pressing firmly. Stretch your arms out. Inhale, come back to center. Let's separate the feet mat width apart. When I say mat width apart, slightly inside the mat. Toes pointing to the side. Now, your hands are going to support your lower back. Be mindful here. We'll bend both knees. Move the thighs forward. So, keeping the knees bent. You can come out to the toes also. You're bringing the knees nice and close towards the floor. And slowly start lifting your hip up. And start sliding your hands down towards your heels. The thighs will shiver. Be mindful. So, both hands moving down towards your heels. We'll stay there for 5. 4. 3. 2. Lift the chest up. And 1. Slowly coming up. Okay, that was a difficult posture. I didn't tell that it was difficult. Otherwise, nobody will try it. So, this time let's try to keep the feet down itself. Okay. We'll bend both knees. So, knees are moving out. The knees are nicely bent. Move the thighs forward. Now support your back with your left hand. And slowly slide your right hand towards your right heel. You're not bringing both hands down. So point the toes out a little bit more if required. So that you can hold on to the heel nice and tight. Now work on only opening the chest up towards the ceiling. As you're pressing the lower back with your left hand. We'll stay there for 3. Thighs will burn. Keep lifting the chest up. 2. Drop your head back. And 1. Chin up. Slowly coming up. A gentle forward fold, keeping the knees bent. Let the hands dangle like an elephant's trunk. You can sway from side to side to release any tension from the lower back. Also, if you felt a lot of pressure in the lower back, it's an indication that the upper body is not being engaged. So, don't forget to keep the upper body engaged. When I say engaged, keep lifting the ribcage up. Hands on hip coming up. Let's do it on the other side. So separate the feet even more wider. That gives you more access towards your heel. Toes are pointing to the side. Knees bent. So knees are moving close to the floor. Okay, almost close to the floor. Not touching the floor, but close to the floor. Now support your back with your right hand. You can look down and slowly see if you can move towards your left heel. So once you have the grip, all fingertips there, lift chest up, open chest, squeeze your shoulder blades, dropping your head back. Your right hand is supporting you so that the hip keeps moving forward. We'll stay there for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, slowly coming up. Again, folding forward, folding on your opposite elbows. Let go of your upper body. Bend the knees so that any tension from the lower back releases. Let's lie down on our belly again. Just lift the head up and you're going to hold on to your upper arm with both your hands. So holding on to the upper arm, your elbow, shoulders in one line. Now press the knee, lifting the trunk up. So I repeat, you're lying down, you're bringing the interlaced hand, which is holding on to your upper arm, beneath your chest. So if you drop your head down, so your hands are just beneath your chest. So lift the head up, press the knee, lift the hip up. And slowly start stretching your hip back. Don't let go of the grip of your elbows. You're trying to bring the chest and the chin down. So toes are pointed out. You can separate the knees even more if that's comfortable. Chest, chin pressing down. Eyes closed for a few seconds. Start relaxing your shoulders and armpits. Deep breath in and out.
If there's a lot of pressure in the chin, lift the head up, stretch the neck, and then place the bottom part of the chin, not the tip of the chin, but beneath that.
Slowly let's come out of the practice. Coming on to all fours, holding plank for the next 10 counts. So wrist, shoulders in one line, stretch both your legs up, tuck the tailbone in, heels pointing up towards the ceiling, gaze forward. So gripping the mat with the 10 tips of your fingers, shoulders are broad, keep breathing, belly is in, strong legs for 10. I'm counting 9. Still counting 8. 7. Anytime the back arches, see if you can squeeze your tummy in a little bit more. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Let's bring the knees down. Sitting back in child's pose. Hands by the side, forehead down. Let's bring the hip down. Take your time. So lift the chest up. Bringing the hip down. We're going to stretch both the legs out. Toes pointing towards you. So what we're going to do is we're going to keep the legs engaged, sitting up straight. And you'll walk both the hands towards the left side. So you're walking the hands towards the left side. You can walk the left hand back a little bit more. But ensure that you're pressing the hips down firmly. So without lifting the buttock up, slowly try to bring the head closer towards your left palm. See if the head can touch down. Gentle lift of the right buttock is okay. We'll stay there for 3. 2. Toes pointing towards you, strong legs. And 1. Inhale, come back to center. Now you see when I do it on the other side, my left side of the hip will slightly lift up. But I'm trying my best to keep it down. So both hands moving towards the right side. Adjust, don't go back too deep. You can be on the side itself. As you're pressing your buttock down, slowly trying to bring the crown of the hip down. We'll stay there for 5. 4. Head is moving towards the right palm. 3. Right elbow can come down. 2. And 1, slowly coming up. Let's stretch, keep the legs stretched out. Bringing the right leg in half lotus, Ardha Padmasana. So take your time. Try your best to bring the back of the foot close to the hip crease. So your toes are engaged. The right foot, the toes are pointing down, toes are engaged. Now just check if you can wrap your right hand around, holding on to the right foot. If that's not happening, just wrap the hand around, placing it on the lower back. But ensure that you are consciously rolling the right shoulder back. Left toes pointing towards you. Inhale, left arm reaching up. Exhale, folding forward. Again, you're gazing at your left big toe. If your body structure is too thin like mine, the hip bone might press on to the foot. So if that's happening, lift the foot up a little bit more. And let the top of the feet be above the hip bone so that the hip bone doesn't hurt your foot. 3 more breaths here. 3. 2. Keep tightening your left thigh. Gaze at your left big toe. And 1. Exhale, touch down, forehead down. Inhale, lifting up. We'll bend the left knee, holding on to the left foot. So before we straighten the left leg, see how far can you move the right knee down. It's a deep stretch for the ankle, so be mindful. Choice to stay here where you're only trying to bring the right knee down. Otherwise, squeeze the belly in. and take your time to stretch the left leg out. Gaze down at one point, stretching the left leg out. Right knee keeps moving down, holding it 5, 4. Keep lifting the chest up. Choice to point the left foot towards you. 3, 2, and 1. Exhale, releasing. The legs remain in the same place. Right leg is stretched. Sorry, left leg is stretched out. Right leg in Padmasana. We're going to roll back to Halasana from here. So inhale, take a deep breath in. Exhale, press the elbows down, rolling back. Left foot coming down. And the right knee can also come down if that's comfortable for you. Otherwise, try to lift the right knee, bring the right thigh parallel to the floor. We'll stay here for 3. Straighten the left knee out completely. 2 and 1. Bend the left knee softly. Use hands as your brakes. Slowly lower the hip down. So coming down, one vertebra down at a time, engaging your belly. Hands act as brakes. And then coming up to seated. Let's stretch both the legs out. Hands behind your hip. Relax your thighs. Let the thighs roll out. Eyes closed for the next few seconds. Just watch your right ankle, right knee, calf muscle, thigh. Let the entire right leg relax. Now moving on to the other side. We'll keep the leg stretched out. Left leg, we'll bring it in half lotus. So the first posture where we are holding the shin with the elbows. If this was too uncomfortable, then Padmasana might also be uncomfortable. So take your time. So move the heel up. Try to point the sole of the foot up. And don't press the thigh too firmly with the hand. You can just place the palm. See how far it goes down gently. So choice to stay here itself. You can sit here, lengthen spine. That's also a good stretch for your legs and the hips. Right toes pointing towards you. Now see if the left hand can wrap around holding on to the left foot. That's not happening, placing it on the back of lower back. Inhale, lifting the right arm up. Exhale, folding forward. So keep pointing the right foot towards you. Inhalation, crown of the head moves forward, flatten out your spine. Exhalation, press the belly close to your heel. Choice to bring your chin beyond your knee. Only if it's accessible. Otherwise, work on only lengthening your spine. When you're looking at the camera, to stretch the spine out. We'll stay there for 5. Sorry, not looking at the camera, looking at the screen. 4. Deep breaths out. 3, 2, and 1. Exhale out, inhale, chest up. Let's bend the right knee. So before we do anything, just see how far can the right knee come down. Sorry, left knee come down. Now bring the buttocks down. See how far the knee is willing to move down. Be mindful, it's a deep stretch for the ankle. Now we'll hold on to the left foot. Exhale out fully, chest is lifted. Inhale, slowly start straightening the right leg out. As you start dropping the left thigh down, holding it for 5. If this is not accessible, regular Navasana, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly bringing the right leg down. Again, the legs remain in the same place. If previous posture was not accessible, getting into regular Halasana. Okay. Inhale, lengthen spine, exhale, press the elbows down, roll back, right foot coming down. And you can choose to use your left palm to bring the left thigh parallel to the floor. Both palms are down, palms pressing down.
Stretch the right leg out completely. Even if the right big toe is not touching ground perfectly, okay. Let's start using our shoulders and palms as brakes and slowly start lowering down. Upper back, squeeze your belly. Middle back, squeeze your belly more. And then finally bringing the lower back down. Stretching both the legs out. Separate your feet nice and wide. Hands by the side. Eyes closed for a few seconds. Complete awareness moving towards your left thigh. Let's come up to seated. We'll try one more posture. I'll give modifications if that's not accessible. First is to get the legs in Padmasana. So keep the feet separated, thighs rolling out. We'll bring the right leg, placing the right leg in half lotus. So ideally the knee is almost in front of you. And then see if you can lift the left leg, placing it on top of the knee. If this is not happening, don't try too hard. You can keep the leg down itself beneath the right leg. Those who want to try, just use both your hands, hold on to the shin, lift, place the heel up, and then you're going to bring the heels closer. I suggest you watch the posture first and then we'll go do it together. So either you're in Padmasana, I'll show the modification when you're not in Padmasana also. So we'll slowly bring the elbows down and we'll bring the hands beneath our buttocks. Okay? So the knees are lifting up, you're lifting the chest up. We'll inhale here, holding the breath, Jalandhar Bandh, chin to chest. Chin up, exhale out fully, releasing your hands, coming up to Padmasana. Okay, we'll go together. But before that, if you're not in Padmasana, the left leg can be down. You can still bring your elbows down, place your palms beneath your buttock. Lift the right knee and the left foot off. So you have to keep the left leg engaged. Lift the chest up. Inhale there. Hold breath in. Chin to chest. Jalandhar Bandh. Chin up. Exhale and release. So when you are not in Padmasana, your left leg or the leg that is released will start shivering, which is perfectly okay. Let's go together. Right leg first and then left leg on top of right. Straight spine, slowly as you're lifting the knee up, bring the elbows down. So don't lift the knee up too high. Placing the right buttock onto your right palm, left buttock onto your left palm. Knees pointing up in 45 degrees. Inhale, lift chest up, hold breath in, chin down. Gaze at nostril. Chin up, exhale, coming back to seated. Palms on knees, straight spine, eyes closed. Let's try the other side. Let's bring the left leg in half lotus first and then right leg to complete your Padmasana. Padmasana is not happening, stick to Ardha Padmasana. Sit up tall. As you're lifting the knee, bring the elbows down. Place the palms beneath your buttock. Inhale, lift chest up. Walk the elbows in slightly. As you're lifting the chest up, take one more deep breath in. Hold breath in. Chin down, gaze at nostril. Chin up, exhale, releasing your hands. We'll repeat it once more. And just observe how the body feels once you come up to seated.
Again bringing the elbows down, palms supporting your buttock. Lift the chest up. Inhale there. Hold breath in. Chin to chest. Gaze at nose tip. Chin up. Exhale. Come up to seated. Even simple cross leg is okay. Palms on knees. Just observe your body. Observe your breath. Slowly releasing your legs if you are in Padmasana. Getting into shoulder stand. We'll keep the legs stretched out. Let's bring the elbows down first. Okay. We'll try to work with the core a little bit to lift the legs up. So let's lift the leg 45 degree up. Now as you're bringing the shoulders down, exhale, hip lifts up. Inhale, hip down. So squeeze your tummy. Exhale, hip lifts up. Inhale down. So you're not in full shoulder stand yet. So shoulders are down, palms down. Exhale, hip up. Inhale down. Exhale, hip up. Inhale down. Last two. Exhale, hip up. Inhale down. This time coming up fully. Exhale, coming up. Support your lower back. See if you can walk your elbows in. Ideally, you are trying to make the chest touch the chin. Back of the head is comfortable. Toes pointed out. Choice to switch to Ujjayi breathing. Chest breathing, where you are breathing in and out with a sound from the throat. A choice to be in regular breath, keeping the eyes closed. Relax your shoulders down. Upper arm pressing firmly onto the mat. Eyes are closed, opening your eyes. We'll try to find balance in our shoulders by bringing our arms stretched out in front of our legs. Nirlamba Sarvangasana. So be mindful, your tummy has to be slightly engaged. First stretching the right arm in front of your leg. If you're too scared, you can just support the knee with the right hand and then left hand stretches out. Draw the belly in to straighten the legs out. Keep lifting the hip up for 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Elbows down, support your back. Bend both knees, knees onto your forehead. Stay here for a few seconds. Awareness to your feet, ankles, calf muscles. And slowly roll up to seated. We'll do simple breathing practice. Any position okay. Vajrasana, half lotus, full lotus, or simple cross leg, whichever works for you. You can get a cushion to keep the spine straight. If you think that sitting down your back rounds, have a cushion, give a lift to your hip, sit up straight. So we'll be breathing in and out through the left nostril 10 times. And then we'll switch to breathing in and out through the right nostril 10 times. I repeat. First, we'll complete 10 breaths in and out through left and then 10 breaths in and out through right. Count will be as per your breath. So first, we'll keep our eyes closed. We'll watch our breath. See what count works for you. So if you think you're counting 1, 2, 3 as the breath, the exhale will be the same. 1, 2, 3. So once you have the count, while you're sitting still. Keep that count in mind, and when you're inhaling, exhaling through the nostril, we'll just make the counts as Om. So if you have three count, then it will be Om, Om, Om when you're inhaling, Om, Om, Om when you're exhaling. So you can go up till a count of 10 if that's comfortable for you. But remember, no excessive force put in to breathe in and out. It's calm breath with gradually kind of increases in pace and duration. Not pace, in duration. Okay. First step, both palms on knees. Let the index and the thumb finger touch each other. Jnana Mudra. Lengthen spine, shoulders relaxed, elbows relaxed. Closing your eyes. Bring a gentle smile onto the face. And just watch your breath. Your inhalation and exhalation. There's a gentle expansion of your belly and the chest as you're inhaling. And very slow contraction of your chest and belly as you're exhaling. Now pick a count that works for you. I'm going to watch my breath for a few more seconds along with you to pick a count. I'll tell you what my count is, but you stick to your count. So my count is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'll be replacing that with Om, 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 Om. Exhale Om, 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 Om. Once you've found your count, let's move on to a left nostril. So 10 breaths in and out with a mental chant of Om that works with the count that you have found for your breath. We lift the right hand, closing the right nostril gently. Exhaling out through left and starting the practice now. Straight spine, shoulders relaxed. If you already done with 10 counts, please switch to the right side. I am switching to the right now, closing the left nostril with the ring finger. Awareness at the eyebrow center now. Straight spine, shoulders relaxed, face relaxed. So done with 10 rounds. Both palms on knees in Jnana Mudra. Sitting straight, observing both the nostrils for the next 30 seconds. Absolute stillness in the body. Gently blink open your eyes. Brahmari practice. We'll try a different variation also. See what works for you. So keeping your eyes soft, I'll show you the options. First option is to sit still and you'll be using your thumb or the index or the middle finger to close your ears. You can press inside the ears or the flap of the ear, whichever is comfortable for you. Elbows pointing to the side. So you'll be inhaling and exhaling the humming sound. Just ensure that the jaws are not locked when you are exhaling. So jaws are relaxed, face relaxed. You will be inhaling and exhaling on. With the jaws separated slightly. This is option 1. Option 2 is you are going to squat down where your elbows are placed on the knee. Just like how you would have seen people drinking tea in the mountain regions. You're going to place the elbows on the knee. We'll be cupping our ears with both our hands and doing the same practice. So your head will be tilted down slightly, but spine remains straight. So choose what works for you. I am choosing this option. 6 rounds of Brahmari and then we'll lie down onto the mat for Shavasana. Closing your ears. So choose. If you're sitting down, either you can close, put no, insert the finger inside the ear or close the flap of the ear. Let's all start together. Exhale out fully. Relax your jaws. Inhale, breath in. 6 rounds at your own pace. the eyes closed. Once you're done with 6 rounds, lying down in Shavasana. Take your time, hands away from your body, chin to chest, legs separated. Complete awareness to our head, back of the head, top of the head. Any sensation that you can feel on your face. Stillness in the body, awareness with the entire head, Shavasana. Feel like staying longer, please stay longer in Shavasana till your body requests you to come out. Otherwise, coming out with me, start moving your toes, fingers, joining your feet together. Give a good stretch to your body. Inhale there as you're stretching your body, and exhale, bend both knees, roll to the right side. Keeping the eyes closed, coming up to seated. Simple cross leg. Palms together. Relaxing your eyes, eyelids, rub palms. Place them on the eyes. And slowly blink open into your palms. Thank you everyone for practicing with me today. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a good day. Stay happy, stay fit, stay peaceful. Bye.